Good evening. My name is Stephanie Sanchez, your host for this evening. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to our presentation tonight. Tonight, the Choral Department of East Mecklenburg hopes to transform this public school auditorium into a theater on that fabulous, famous thoroughfare in Manhattan, Broadway. Yes, tonight, folks, you will get your money's worth. Not one wonderful Broadway show, but five. Five memorable musical scores highlighting some of the greatest music on Broadway from 1927 to 1981. We hope you will recognize several of the beautiful melodies sung tonight. We hope that you will be entertained by the dance moves we've learned and the costumes we've acquired. We hope that there will be faces both here in the pit and up on this stage that you will recognize that will make you smile. That's right, folks, smile. You see, each performer tonight has made a journey in his or her own development the last 8 weeks, and it is their great joy to share with you tonight the fruits and labor and dedication. It is our hope that for one moment or more, you might forget just where you are and might feel that power, that magic of the great white way known as Broadway. So let's begin with no further delay. Cats is on its way. Based on 14 poems by T.S. Eliot called Old Possum's Book of Practical Cats, the musical Cats was written by Andrew Lloyd Webber and premiered in London in 1981. In 1997, it surpassed A Chorus Line as being the longest-running musical in the history of Broadway. The show is presently playing in over 250 cities around the world. Sadly to say, though, the New York show will be ending its long run this summer. So, how many of you have seen Cats live in theater? Anybody? How many of you have seen the video of Cats? Any takers? How many of you own a cat? All right. Thank you. All of you then qualify to enjoy the way, the music, and the words make each cat personality come alive. Our performers become cats themselves and are challenged to move and behave in a feline fashion. Like the words in the first song say, what's a Jellicle cat? You help us decide as East Mech presents our version of Cats.
Bell. so whisper down the line at 11:39 when the night mail's ready to depart. All the guards and all the porters and the station master's daughters would be searching high and low.
Saying skimble, very skimble, more, unless he's very nimble, then the night mail just can't go.
At 11:42, with the signal overdue, and the passengers all frantic to a man.
That's when I would appear and I'd saunter to the rear. I'd been busy in the luggage van. Don't freeze if I summon the police, if there was anything they ought to know about.
When they got to Gallagate, then they did not have to wait for Skimble Shanks the doctor to get out. And he gave you a wave of his long road till he says, I'll see you again. You will meet with a fail on the midnight rail.
pretty good considering our light person's not here, huh?
Yeah.
My name is Ms. Snyder, and I work here.
Yeah.
I do. We would like to thank the audience for coming tonight. You seem to be really ready for a good show and a good audience, and we do appreciate that. Thank you for rolling with the punches tonight, and we'll just do the best we can. I have a few things to say, and I'm doing them right now because this is a time when they're taking off that heavy-duty makeup that they wore, and it takes a little bit of time to get that off and put on their regular stage makeup for the balance of the evening. So this will probably take 6 or 7 minutes total for them to make this costume change. Then in between the numbers thereafter should be much shorter, but there will be a little delay in between numbers while they change costumes. An undertaking like this is a huge endeavor. There is no way to tell you the man hours that has gone into this show. I have some people around me that makes this possible. There's no way one person could do this. It would go on all night if I told you everybody who had helped along the way, but there are some very, very special people I would like to acknowledge. Patrick, pull up the house lights, please. Thank you very much. Penny Singleton is the woman responsible for these gorgeous programs that you see. I would estimate, I haven't asked her, but I would estimate she spent 200 to 300 hours doing this program. She personally, she didn't take it to Kinko's. She ran it off at home on her printer. Does that tell you something? She has given us a gift that money can't buy. Somebody's time and dedication to detail like that is priceless. Penny, would you stand and let us thank you for doing all this? It is beautiful, no question about it, and a real keepsake. The people that are in the show, I want to make sure they each get a program for their memory book. As always, my Coral Booster Club is loyal and faithful to come through for me in many, many ways. They have been right along with me step by step during this planning, and I want to thank them, all the ones that serve faithfully on that board. There will be an intermission, as put in the program, of 10 minutes. If you are thirsty, and it is a little warm in here, we're selling sodas for 10-minute intermission, 50 cents for sodas. I got it straight. Okay, 50 cents for sodas out back if you're interested. The facial makeup that we had tonight for cats was done by some moms who gave their time, and I want to thank them. They were wonderful. Didn't you think the faces looked great? Three parents in particular, Olivia Hodge, Marge Longstreet, and Ginger Blackwelder, so I really do thank those folks. I've had a splendid tech crew that has done a marvelous job, everything from drawing the curtain to running the spotlight. They've just been fabulous, so I thank them. And then Mrs. Winiarski's art class did these wonderful panels that hang from the ceiling. She told me that she really let them design them and paint them themselves. So you're looking at student-produced art, and I think it's fabulous. We do thank them so much. Probably the unsung heroes of the evening are the parents of these kids on stage tonight. They would probably not want to tell how much it cost them in terms of time and money. They have supplied the costumes. All these parents have rented, made, borrowed, had people make, Goodwill, all kinds of things for the costumes of the evening. As you see the other musicals unfold, I think this will be one of the features you'll remember about tonight's show. Parents, will you stand and let us thank you for your contribution tonight? Just a reminder, as you get sodas at intermission, that there aren't to be no drinks in the auditorium. We're trying to keep this facility clean, so I appreciate your cooperation. If you see anyone with drinks, just remind them if they will step outside and finish their drink. At this time, we're going to feature two students from the Pit Choir. And I wanted to say that this group down here, they're not usually called the Pit Choir, but for this performance, we refer to them because they sing in the orchestra pit. And they are the ones that help reinforce the sound as the kids on stage leap and dance. It sort of takes their breath, and they can't really project like they normally would. Many of the kids on stage tonight at one time were in the Pit Choir, so it's a wonderful thing to have a working relationship, all the choirs working together. As any coach will tell you, his team is only as good as his bench is strong and deep. Coaches want deep benches, and this is my bench. And we're going to reach in the bench tonight and feature two kids singing I'm 16 Going on 17. Will you welcome Lauren Seeley and Devin Luther?
Better be wary, canny, and careful, baby, you're on the brink. You are 16, going on 17, fellas will fall in line. Eager young lads and rude lads and cads will offer you food and wine. Totally unprepared are you to face a world of men. Timid and shy and scared are you for things beyond your care. You need someone older and wiser telling you what to do. I am 17, going on 18. I'll take care.
Yes, folks, we've got trouble right here in River City. It starts with capital T, that rhymes with P, and that stands for pool. You may remember those famous lines from The Music Man. The plot revolves around Professor Harold Hill, a con man who convinces the good citizens of River City, Iowa, that he can teach their children to play in a magnificent marching band just so that he can sell them band instruments and uniforms. Iowa's stubbornness and honesty bring about a new outlook on life for Hill, who finds he has fallen in love with the town librarian. Instead of skipping town before the instruments arrive, he is convinced to stay. The Music Man opened in Broadway in 1957 with Robert Preston playing Harold Hill. Would you believe that there is a revival of the show in New York City in exactly 2 weeks? Is he smack on the cutting edge or what? Now if you'll all chant, trouble, 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 it will take us right into the streets of River City. Ready? Trouble, 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 trouble. It's the 1950s. I see the New York City skyline. And what's this? A pair of dice? Yep, dice. Nathan Detroit has the oldest floating crap game in town. Why, Nathan will place a bet on anything that's not nailed down. You know, he bet his friend Sky Masterson that he couldn't make the next girl he sees fall in love with him. Funny thing is, that next girl was Sister Sarah Brown, a devoted and determined follower of the local mission to save all the sinners in town. That little bet makes for some hilarious complications. Meanwhile, old Nathan himself finds he has girl problems. His girl, Adelaide, keeps whining that he needs to marry her and settle down. After all, they've only been engaged for 14 years. Will Sky Masterson convince Sister Sarah to eat with him in Havana, Cuba? Will Nathan Detroit be forced to marry Adelaide? You go rent the movie at Blockbuster this weekend. Meanwhile, here are some great songs from this show.
Looks like Nathan's just another victim. money. But it's better than even money. That bad guy's only doing it for some dolls, some dolls, some dolls. The guy's only doing it for some dolls.
Luck be a lady tonight.
Love, 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 love
endure, affecting the epaulette of a toy retract. In other words, just from waiting around for that plain little band of gold, a poison can develop a cold. You can feed her all day with the vitamin A or the Promovit, but the medicine never gets anywhere near where the trouble is. If she's getting a kind of a name for herself, and the name ain't his, a poison can develop a cork. And boy, the mind she's installing, installing, installing the wedding trip. A poison can develop a grip, a grip, a grip, a grip, a postnasal drip. With the wheezes and the sneezes and the sinus, it's really a pip. From a lack of community property and feeling she's getting too old, a poison can develop a bad, bad cold. Achoo!
Last night I got a bottle of wine, by some chance I had four fine dice along in their eyes stood, and I hollered, "Someone save me!" But the passengers, they knew right from wrong. So I said to myself, sit down, you're rocking a boat. People all said, sit down, you're rocking a boat. And it never will drag you under, but a sharp and fun now we check your coat. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, you're rocking the boat. And as I laughed at those passengers to heaven, a great big wave came and washed me overboard. And as I in a holler, someone save me. That's the moment I woke up, thank the Lord.
In 1926, Edna Ferber published the best-selling novel, Showboat. It is a story of three generations of the Hawks family, which owns the river showboat, the Cotton Blossom. Oscar Hammerstein and Jerome Kern were the two men responsible for bringing Ferber's novel to the stage. The original show was produced by Ziegfeld in 1927 and was an immediate success, and serves as an important step in the history of musical theater in America. The story? Oh, yeah. It's about the Old South between 1880 and 1900. The young daughter of Captain Andy falls in love with a riverboat gambler. They get married and leave the showboat for Chicago, where life is very, very good when fortune smiles at the card table. But times get very, very hard when the luck of the draw changes. The marriage breaks up. A child is born. The young lady returns to the showboat to raise her child. One of the subplots is the plight of the black workers and Stevie Doors in the Old South. You may know the most famous song to come from the show, Old Man River. Old Man River, that old man River. He must know something, but don't say nothing. He just keeps rolling. He keeps on rolling along. Oops, I think I see the showboat. We're just around the bend now. Why, it's Captain Andy and the Cotton Blossom for sure.
Like the heroes both He must know something, but don't say nothing. He just keeps rolling. He keeps on rolling along. You and me, we sweat and strain, body all aching and racked with pain. Tote that barge, lift that bale, get a little drunk, and you'll land in jail. I get weary and sick of trying. I'm tired of living and scared of dying. But old man River, he just keeps rolling along.
Andrew Lloyd Webber in 1968, our next show premiered at a small private school in England in a version that was only 20 minutes long. It was extended in 1972 and later modernized as its revival in 1992. Many of you may know the story of Joseph and the many colors from the Bible. Well, you will be a bit surprised to see Joseph and the amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat by Andrew Lloyd Webber. You see, he has retold the story about Joseph, the favored son of Jacob, who was sold into slavery in Egypt. However, Webber used his styles from pop music. For instance, you'll hear the Pharaoh tell his dream about seven fat cows and seven thin cows in the style of Elvis Presley. Each song uses a different modern style, everything from ballad to country to calypso. Well, we think it's a lot of fun. And so our journey to Broadway concludes as it began, with selections by Andrew Lloyd Webber, with a lot of great stuff in between. Thank you for being such a great audience. We hope it's been a memory for you, of shows you love by people you love. Our sincere thanks to the many people who have made this year's review possible. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Joseph and the amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat.
Way back many centuries ago, not long after the wandering along by the banks of the cows came up out of the night. Oh, and right behind these fine, healthy animals came seven other cows that were skinny and vile. Oh, oh, yeah. And then the thin cows ate the fat cows, which I thought would do them good. Oh, 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 yeah. But it didn't make them fatter like a monster supper really should. Oh, yeah. Well, the thin cows were as thin as they have ever been. The stream has got me back. Joseph, won't you tell me what it means? Now you know that kings ain't stupid, but I don't have a clue. So don't be cruel, Joseph. Help me now, I beg of you.